Chapter 3 Important Facts About Goals. Now let's get to some of the cold hard facts about goals. These are not problems. These are necessary for you to know so you don't get discouraged and think you're the lone ranger out there with a problem that no one else has ever had. First, goals keep changing by definition. They have to, don't they, after your trying has reached its end. And that goal has been achieved. Goals only have force when we are striving for them. For example, you wouldn't set a goal to learn how to walk better if you had the health and ability to reach that goal by age 4 or 5. Once you've got walking down pat, that goal loses its impact on you. The force, the happiness, in parentheses, lost when goals are achieved, can be a big disappointment if you aren't prepared for it. After all, when you've taken the time to think about and set goals, you have a right to expect a big path when you reach your goals. Only that's not the way it works, but wait, the way it works is far better. All you have to do is know about it. Another thing about goals, often we feel there's no need to set goals because we're too busy taking care of the immediate problems or demands of life, family, and business. How could we possibly work? It's driving to reach an end. We're at our wits' end most of the time. Anyway, you say to yourself, I'm striving to reach an end the end of the day. Not quite the kind of I'm. And I'm talking about the end of the day is going to arrive whether you strive for it or not, isn't it? And even if you want to take credit for that as one of your goals, you still have the letdown that follows achievement of a goal if you're not prepared. Let me tell you right here that you do not have to set goals. That's right. And you don't need me to tell you that. How many times have you heard others and maybe yourself say, I just go with the flow and take things as they come? You can do that your entire lifetime. And if you happen to have been born into a family that has a classy flow, you may be content to ride on their coattails. If you're content to go with the flow, there's a definite place for you in society. There are plenty of people who will be happy to take advantage of a person like you. It's okay. Though it's your life, it's up to you. It's a choice you make. And in our country, you have freedom to make choices. Be aware, though, that you are making a choice even when you choose not to set goals. It's one of these no-decision decisions, like when the phone company sent you information telling you you could purchase your equipment or keep leasing it from them. If you didn't take action to purchase, the equipment did nothing at all. In effect, you made the decision to go on leasing. There are a lot of no-decisions/decisions like that in life when people have a fear of finality, which is just a way of describing indescribable and describeness. They make many decisions just the way by doing nothing at all. We just have to be aware that we are making the choice even when we fail to take action. When I said earlier that you may not feel it's necessary to set goals because you're too busy taking care of the immediate problems or demands of your life, I was referring to an unintentional choice on your part. When you don't allow yourself to set goals, you basically are choosing to allow your environment to set goals for you. Parentheses, this would be evidenced by T's, and crossed S is very low on your STEM test. And parentheses, just think about it. You still get things, don't you? Are they the things you think are important, or are they just necessary? Do they contribute to your happiness, peace, health, and prosperity? There is a simple fact to goal setting. You are constantly making the choices. Even if you don't realize, are you choosing to allow yourself the sense of personal satisfaction that comes from setting, striving for, and achieving goals? Top of page 16. Choosing to allow yourself the sense of personal satisfaction that comes from setting, striving for, and achieving goals. At one time in my life, I was having trouble sleeping. I went to a psychologist for help and was sleeping fine within 6 months. During that 6 months, my psychologist and I talked about getting married. He is a good Christian man and feels that a woman should not be alone. After I told the psychologist what I wanted in a man, and after he was convinced that I wouldn't settle for less, he accepted the fact that I would not remarry. He told me he thought it was very unlikely I could find a man having all the qualities I demanded. I agreed with him and graciously pointed out that I told him so from the beginning. I'm sure you're way ahead of me. I did find the man I had described. And not only did I find the right traits and personality characteristics, but also the physical characteristics. I didn't realize the latter until after we were married. And I was going through some memorabilia. While packing to move, I found a written description of my dream man I had written when I was a teenager. It listed dark, curly hair, blue eyes, slender, and 6 feet tall, all the important things right in parentheses, you guessed it. My husband, Jim, has dark, curly hair. Not as much now as when he was young. He had blue eyes. He's 160 pounds and exactly 6 foot tall. Be specific in expressing your goals. You can tell if a goal is specific by asking yourself if you can measure the performance leading to the goal. For example, your goal is remember facts better while in meetings in quotation marks. That's good. It's positive. It says that what you want to achieve and where you want to achieve it. You can measure or count the percentage of facts you were able to remember during your last meeting. You can then compare that percentage to the percentage of facts you remembered during your next meeting. In this way, you can track your progress and be certain that you are working towards accomplishing your goal. You can increase your self-confidence and your personal satisfaction. Also, here again, self-awareness is important. State your goal in positive terms above. We stated that the goal is remember facts better in meetings. We didn't say don't forget facts. And meetings see the difference. Remember facts better in meetings says what you want to do, what's important to you to accomplish. We want to concentrate on what you want to accomplish to achieve. Say to yourself, I don't want to forget facts. Okay. Now, we know what you don't want to do. What do you want to do? This is an important point. Please take it seriously. Studies done on the functioning of the mind have proved you need positive statements to facilitate goal achievement. Place your goal in a specified environment. In the goal above, we said we want to remember facts better in meetings. The environment we're dealing with is that of the meeting. This is needed so you can measure your progress aside. Also, if your goal is to be more relaxed, you want to specify where and when. You might say, I want to remain relaxed, and explaining tasks to my subordinates. You wouldn't want to remain relaxed all the time. What if the building you're in catches fire? You don't want to sit relaxed and become overcome by smoke. Break major goals down into sub-goals. In this way, you can plot your progress.